recording. Okay, now it's recording as well. This is me, Sander, aka at Sander underscore Dota. With me is Morality Class. We're both from Swiss DC, and we haven't really casted something in a while. So we decided to just go into some pubs and cast some random matches. For now, we actually found one from the Sindarin Dota, from the DC, the analytical cast. And we thought, well, let's just take his match, go over it, see what he does, and see what everybody else in this about 6k MMR game, I believe, does. And maybe we'll learn something and at least have some fun. I hope Morality is all ready for it.
Yeah, I am. The only thing is that the name on the stream is probably very wrong.
What name? Did I put your name wrong, incorrectly?
No, it's Vague Female. I don't think we've got...
Oh, yeah, I was too lazy to do that.
All right, then. That's fine. All right, yeah,
I'm changing it now.
Oh, I am ready, and let's have a look. Sindarin's team, Dire, versus the other team, Radiant.
Yeah, you go over it while I'm typing.
All right, so we have a Queen of... So on the Radiant side, we have A... playing a Queen of Pain, Furry playing an Undying, BSG playing the Wind Ranger, the Sneznok playing a Keeper of the Like, and a Spectro being played by twitch.tv/ntngspcl. Okay.
I honest for God, I'm pretty sure that should be a Russian because that could never be an English name. Yeah, I'm not gonna try it. For the die set, I believe we had some easier names. Lich is gonna be played by Mads. Yeah, Sindarin, of course, on the Doom. He has like a cosmetic for every hero. This one he stole from EG.
Right.
Then we have a Disruptor. Right. And it doesn't look like he has... No, he doesn't have the Immortal, so... Yeah, that's not something that young Mads...
Where is Disruptor? I don't... Seem to be having some kind of graphicals district for me. Disruptors are floating orb. Oh, I see it.
What's a floating orb? How the hell did you do that?
No, some. Oh, sorry, I meant Magnus. Magnus wasn't floating in. Magnus has. No, there he is. Okay.
Magnus is the one.
He has reconnected.
Whoop whoop. Space dash Magnus. And we have bit on the gyrocopter. Let's see. Do we have any funky things in the inventories? Mango for Doom, but that's not that impressive anymore. Does mean that he has absolutely no armor to speak of with this build.
Spectra has not bought any... No, hang on. Yes, she has. No, Spectra has bought starting items. I was accidentally selected the melee barracks.
I believe this is something that at least, you know, Zach always wants to talk about. Yeah, you need to get 8 tangos in your core. Position 1. It's what Dirty Rat does. So he always buys fucking 8 tangos. And Spectre does the same one.
Well, I mean, if we're going to assume average MMRs here, like about 5k, 6k, you know?
6k-ish, yeah.
So, I'm going to say, I mean...
No, in this case, I totally agree with it.
Yeah.
Like, you're most likely going to be facing off against dual lane.
Yeah, with the Doom and the Lich. And Lich is a horrible laner to lane against.
Yeah, you're going to keep on getting spammed of the... The Frost Blast and...
Oh yeah, and Sacrifice, of course, taking away all those XP now with that change.
Yeah, it's...
Nice,
Nice. It's gonna be really hard, so that's why they do that. Like, in this case, I agree with it, but Zac just does it every single game. Like, even if we have two supports versus one offlane who doesn't even come close to the lane, he steals like fucking 8 tangos.
Although, like, I don't think the top lane is gonna be pretty... I think the top lane is gonna be pretty harsh as well. They've got an Undying on the top lane, which, I mean, nerfed early game, I'm gonna say, but... His late game is now so much stronger. It's still going to be very hard to lane against. It's an Undying, you know.
Yeah, it's also the thing. Yeah, once he has an Aghanim Scepter, then late game he's actually really, really, really hard to deal
with. Yeah, like, if you like...
just think about it. If you have 5 men in the DK, he hits all of them, he gets plus 50 strength. So plus 50 damage, plus what is it, 500?
Yeah, he gets about like two DKs, yeah.
About plus 900 HP as well. So, when you think about it, nobody is even close to 900 HP right now, and he can get it in like one click on off the bottom, plus 900 HP.
Now, the thing is, though, you said like they need to be clumped, and the thing is that...
They don't.
They don't have any initiation that let them clump people together.
Yeah, this is
No,
it's like, but still, they have a lot of good team fight. Yeah.
If you got two people clumped up already, because that's like something that's gonna happen, like for sure, whenever you're gonna try and focus somebody.
Yeah,
up,
yeah, yeah.
Then you already get like, what is it, 360 HP from it. So.
Definitely. Yeah.
So it's stacking up really fast. The thing is, you need to get there. And that's like by far the hardest point. I've been experimenting with it as well. So. As we might have a little bit of fight here on the top rune. The battle begins. I think they have to give it up to the right here.
Oh dear.
Oh yeah. Hey, he has to blink out. There you go.
They never blink never. Oh, she's actually rotating top. They're probably going to put the wind rain on mid.
Oh yeah, yeah. That was how they wanted to do it from the beginning. However, with level 1 blink on the Queen of Pain,
that doesn't work so well, yeah.
The range size now is a little bit of a weak dual lane for at least the first minute or so, because they're going to be splitting the experience as well. So it does, yeah. Dying might be able to keep them out a bit, but even if he gets close, he's just going to get Rocket Barrage as well.
It's not the best synergy disruptor Gyrocopter, however, you know.
What?
Right, you can use the rocket. I mean, you have to time it very well. There are better synergies. I mean, it works.
Oh yeah, for sure. Some levels in it, and you can just. Once you arrest somebody out with the Rocket Barrage and they start running away, you just get them back in and you give them a second solve of the Rocket Barrage. One problem is their Gyrocopter is really low on HP in the beginning, so these two decays already stack up pretty heavily.
It looks like they're actually going to start roaming towards the Disruptor, but you'll see it.
And here, but yeah, you can already see Spectre has in some troubles. It's getting a CS, but... taking a fair amount.
Ooh, Cinderin?
Yeah, this is all his mana gone. They can't kill him, like, no chance, but... Yeah, this does mean that Devourer is not gonna be used as much.
It's a shame, because he really does need those levels.
Yeah, nah, the Devourer is mostly, you just get that gold. That's all.
Gold and levels. It's like... Although offline, I don't think he's gonna... He's not gonna go with Radiance, of course. Or is he? I don't think so.
There are like different builds that you can go, like so many options. You kind of have to wait for later. Most people tend to go for, what is it? Either Radiance or Midas, just to really use the Devourer gold that you can stack up.
Get that farm going.
But yeah, this game, even a Blink Dagger is not that good because you're playing against a Spectre. It's not the most.
You can just press that R, you know.
And then make sure that nobody comes close.
Queen of Pain now getting some solo XP for a bit, while the Undying decides to roam and get that rune. Could be... The Magnus isn't having the best of times mid, versus a Windranger of course.
Yeah, I was just looking at it, 6 denies and 14 less hits on the Windranger versus the 6 hits from the Magnus here.
Yeah, it's that intense range from the Windranger. She's got 600 attack range, that's... Diaper range almost.
Yeah, it's pretty close to that at least. And the thing is that like with a Magnus, sometimes you can catch people off guard and just drag them all the way back into your tower. Like no chance now this is gonna happen with the Windranger.
Because she's just gonna, she's just gonna stand out of your attack range and be like denying all your creeps.
And before you're there, you just throw out the Shackle Shot and you Shackle to your own creeps, and you're like, yeah, this wasn't the plan.
Like, in order to get that done, you need a blink, and he's obviously not gonna have that within 5 minutes.
I do want to say on Cinderin, I like that the troll creep or the troll with the unholy aura.
It's so much sustain there. You could just
Seder.
Stay along. Oh dear.
Yeah.
Beep of the Light's getting a gank off on him.
Yeah, and he might as well die. Now as well. He can just run underneath the tower. Like, there you go. He finishes it off with the blast and just gets easy first blood here.
Very well played. I mean. Deep of the Light only slightly off guard, and already Cinderin uses that to his advantage.
Yeah, now look at the Spectre. Like, he has to take a little bit of step back. As soon as he's going to be out of regeneration as well. And then he's going to be having a whole lot of trouble. Like, then he just can't stand up here anymore.
And that Mana Burn doesn't really do much. Stuns him for a bit, but what's the point?
Yeah, he was already low mana. But again, like, that means that he can't use the power as much as he wants.
I don't think he cares anymore, though. I think he already one kill is pretty good.
Well, he got his button out, so now he can start using it again. So that was what he's going for. Like, this just means that this lane is, like, completely self-reliant. They can just take the runes and then they can be here pretty much forever.
Well, that's it. And Spectre is just going to have such a hard time finding farm after this, especially. Just considering the fact that she's not a good farmer from the get-go. She really needs farming items, and versus this lane, who can just keep harassing her out of the lane, it's going to be really hard.
Oh man, did you see that Chakra Magic? It's like, here, have some magic. Oh, you can still cast anything at all. Yeah, level 1 Chakra Magic's pretty underwhelming.
I mean, the cooldown reduction is pretty nice, but...
if you don't have mana to cast it, it doesn't matter.
Exactly. It's like, what's the point?
Oh my god. Just like saying,
oh, yeah, Spectre's now. Spectre's now in the...
Yeah, he's in the
shadow.
Oh, he's dead.
I think I'm gonna go right back.
He just ate the mango just to chase him down with the mana burn on him. Like, yeah, I want you dead. I don't care. Let's follow you up.
Yeah, that's it for the Spectrum, I'm gonna say.
Yeah, this is gonna be hard. Like, now it's a real comeback. Like, the Windranger needs to get his face boost now, get a TP on the courier, and then just get his ass down to bot, have the Keeper of the Light behind the tower with a smoke, and go instantly for a kill. Like, that's like the first priority right now that they should do.
Sadly, but they're rotating the Keeper of the Light top. They're rotating the Keeper of the Light top.
But they want to keep the Gyro from farming, but that's already too late.
Yeah, he's already gone. Yeah. Well, boots, I mean, but... young Mad, they brought the Coombsong down.
Yeah, they're gonna get the Disruptor, but that's probably about all.
They might as well...
the tower.
I was thinking maybe they're gonna try something funny, is diving the tower with the Undying, but would've been very risky.
And, hey, welcome back, Manic. With one person in chat.
Yay, man, hang on, don't I know him?
I think so.
Oh, Manic.
I'm terrible at names and faces though, so... The Rimmer Sponge shit. I would say that actually Magnus had made a nice comeback here. Still, of course, a bit behind, like 8 creeps and 8 denies actually in both. But it's still...
Oh, he's got his RP.
Yeah, he got his RP.
Back. He's got level 2 skew. You know, he's doing fine. He hasn't died, so that's also an advantage.
Yeah, that's like the whole thing about it.
Oh, Jared. And now
and a dying glimpse back as well, ready for a bit, waiting for him, getting in some hits. He gets off a DK, but it doesn't matter. Cinderandota comes in, gets his killing spree, gets his compendium points. He just needs to win the game.
That's all he did. It's just like, I'm just gonna come right here to get a kill, and then I'm gonna walk right back to the bottom lane.
Maybe
no, he's probably gonna go mid.
He's going mid.
Yeah.
Magnus is going back to the base, take over some juicy experience over there. Leech is just fine versus Spectre alone. It's more the Spectre's just... even resorted to pulling. Like, then you know that you're in the shithole.
Yeah. And she's not gonna have any farming items within the next few minutes, and that's exactly what the Dire wants right now.
Yeah. Just having a Basilius and a Portman shield is not having a battle ready.
It's not the same as a Radiant.
No, but in 8 minutes having a Radiance would be...
Yeah, it would be pretty impressive, but I mean, you already have these items. You expect to have these items, like, at least, you know, 5 minutes in if you're doing well. Maybe have some boots as well. Oh my god, that's a lot of damage.
This is going to be a really aggressive Lich. He's not going to stop for this. He goes full YOLO. But there is,
they're sharing the aggro, but Spectre...
It doesn't matter. He got out in time, but oh no, there's a Cinderin. Cinderin is looking for him, but... Oh, he comes out! Cinderin, they get a totem on top of them as well, and this is gonna be the pass. The Magnus pass. Oh no. This might just be unpassed, because this is a little bit of a weird situation to pass in.
I don't know, will Cinderin... Cinderin might go right in on the Spectre and just brave the Tombstone. Level 2.
Yeah, Spectre's gonna get healed up now with the Soul Rip. You can see the animation coming from the Undying. Also, when you click
I see it. Is it gonna do much, though? It's only level 1, and aren't too many creeps around. It's gonna be good, but you know.
He needs to put it instantly on the Spectre. If the Spectre shows himself instantly on Spectre, throw in the Blast. I actually forgot the name. Shockwave. Actually, never knew that one.
The same as the Magnus ability.
Empower?
Yeah, RP? Shockwave. Skewer? Shockwave. Shockwave and Shockwave.
Actually, the difference is one space in the middle. No, what is actually the same? Well, what? Does it do the same damage? Like, how much is it?
No,
not even close, I guess.
That's only 125 damage, but will he do, maybe?
Well, if he sees the Spectre, yeah, he's gonna get healed up. Was it 180 now, I believe? A little bit
about.
They're not 10 units.
Like five, maybe about six, half.
Seven units at the moment. Maybe a zombie spawn, so about eight. Eight units. 8 times 18. Well, you're my technical guy.
8
so you
times
can...
18.
I'm too lazy. I know what it is. It's 160.
Yeah, 60. About 100. 16,
right?
118 times 8,
oh,
eight is 160. Oh, 6.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, man. It's about 100, mate.
Yeah, 116.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Dude!
No. Hang on. You said 18 times 8.
Oh yeah, oh,
yeah. But that's 160.
Oh, yeah.
About.
Oh, yeah. About that, yeah. Well, at least we can count. That's good enough.
Mathematics are hard, ladies and gentlemen.
For us, it is. Did you check the stream for the sound and stuff?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, good. Oh, long pause, man. At 6K, they're way too nice to each other. I would have been paused like an hour ago. Fucking hell.
Maybe I'm a bit too loud.
You're too loud?
I might just say that. Yeah, maybe.
You're too loud? Okay, then I'm just going to put my own mic louder. Here you go.
Ah, fine. Assert dominance, I assume.
No, it's more like if you're too loud, that means that the sound from my computer is too much. So it means that my game sound is also too loud. So if I just, you know, amplify my own damage. Because I have my damage.
You amplify your own damage, eh?
Yeah, damage to the hearings.
So you
if I amplify my own level, it should be good. Or at least at my own level. Because it's like, I put it at like 50 or something on OBS.
Dude.
So now it's good. So good.
Look at the gyro, he's living life on the edge.
He's living life on, I'm gonna go back to base ASAP.
Yeah. Might as well just grab the creep camp. Although, that's 45 health. Incredibly risky.
Well, it depends on whether or not the enemy sees him, and I guess enemy doesn't.
you can see the
I believe they just killed one of them as well, who's rotating out, they're suddenly dying, going bot. Spectre is now level 6. You see the Wind Ranger and the Cottle. He's not one to smoke up and go behind enemy lines to find a 45 HP gyrocopter lying around. Like, that's...
You see, we don't have a bounty this game.
Okay.
The game is unpausing. Let's have a look, bots. And Syndrome stands still.
And he actually goes for the Doom on the.
Yeah,
they're doing a lot of damage here. Is he gonna just blow him up? He doesn't have the mana for it, but still, it should be a kill on him. Might be able to deny himself, though. Yeah, there you go. He denies himself. He thought it was easy to get out, but now there's gonna be rotation in. Yeah, he's already dead. There we go. Spectre, he's gonna get seen, but. Not pursued because now the disruptor is a little bit stuck here. Wind Rage sees him, Shackle Shot is not gonna lash on the tree, but still the damage with the DD is more than real.
I think a glimpse there might have worked, but
no,
in the end.
I don't think so, to be honest. He was already hitting way too fast, like, even if he glimpsed, it doesn't make a difference. And now the boss come back to wait for the Magnus. As said, I wasn't expecting them to do this.
Yeah, no, just the Wind Ranger rotating down with the DD'd huge amounts of damage, and it's over.
And this is what they need to do. They need to make space for Spectre. And the good thing
Although you have to think, Dire was incredibly over-aggressive there.
That's true. But then you can punish it quite easily. Yeah, they were actually quite elite as well, like almost 3k in gold and about 3k in experience as well, so... 6 minutes, that's actually a pretty big lead, hope.
Still, I mean, it's an early game, it's like... There still aren't the huge items, there still aren't, you know, like the huge abilities that are highly leveled, so being overly aggressive in the early game will get punished very easy if a team knows how to, and in this case they did.
Less online 5 minutes ago. Oh man, that's not good. Can I look at it as well? I actually don't have the chat on. Let's see if people are saying stuff in the thing. Can you type something? Maybe I see it.
No. No, nobody's saying anything.
So it's not me. Okay.
Yeah, this guy. Yeah. Ukraine, I see. Okay.
From, was it space? Yeah.
Space station. Okay, apparently they have problems over there. Ah, well.
Yeah, well, this is some, well, actually, usually when you're playing 4-5, you get a big influx of gold all the time, which is pretty nice. One thing is that they're not going to win late game. So essentially, then for the rain, it is just get through the first time that the gold influx comes, just survive through it, and just bank off that. Like, you have a Spectre in the wind range, you should be able to easily out carry a Doom plus Gyrocopter. And then you also have
the Spectre, like, hardest late game carry, anyway.
Well,
but the problem is,
there's things to be said for Medusa and stuff as well.
Yeah, well, the problem with Medusa, I feel like, is that, I don't know, really, to be honest. I feel like she just doesn't have the strength that Spectre has.
She just can't get close. Like, that's a big problem. Like, if you want to get close to someone, they have to initiate on us. And that's kind of the thing for the hero. It's a hero that you pick when the enemy has run at you kind of heroes. Like, if the enemy has spear breakers, those kind of things. He runs at you, and just before he hits you, you just press your R, and you're like, yep, and now what you gonna do? And then from there on, you can just take a quite easy team fight. You know, us versus heroes like Queen of Plain, that Blinkin. Anything that
thing is, though, I feel like commits. You know, like, Spectre is incredibly mobile with a Spectre Dagger and a Desolate. And I feel like the Queen of Desolate Horns. And I feel like the, what's it called? Medusa just doesn't have the mobility that Spectre has. Even if she does have her ult, which is great for team fights, it requires a very specific setup to be activated, you know?
Yeah.
Whereas Spectre can just press R and be like, I'm going to be in a team fight all the way across the map now, and then I can get back to farming, and that's probably what makes her so powerful.
That's true.
So, you know, it's just the map-wide mobility of the Spectre versus the more or less static defense of the Medusa. Dire's top tower is under attack. Glitch.
Oh no. This might just be a little bit over-aggressive as well. Are they able to get a return kill on the Wind Ranger here?
No.
No. That was too much. A little bit too aggressive.
Yeah, Wind Ranger playing her game here.
Even I think she could even just run away from the Doom, at least if they get a rotation in. But
I mean, she got two kills with the DD.
It's worth it. Like that's how you need to use your DD. Now Spectre comes up, they're gonna gank the Gyrocopter with a cooldown. Like, this is not gonna happen. Like, they don't even try it. Just get to lane and farm.
Oh, they're bringing the Magnus top. Someone's micro-ing the Magnus.
Yeah, why not? Or maybe one of the supports or something. But yeah, Spectre, this is just like a wasted TP top. 100. Oh no, they changed it. 75 right now? Yeah, 75G. Plus walking there, no rune. Essentially about a minute or so wasted plus some gold. It's not good. Oh no. RP on the very edge. Oh, this skewer almost looked like it was gonna miss. But there's gonna be the Remnant running away. Totem dropped just to keep him out, putting in some DKs. Totem gets destroyed as he heals up, I believe, a creep. There's gonna be the glimpse back on Fury. He is now stuck here. Is he able to get maybe off a DK? He needs 1 second
the micro,
for it.
The micro.
There are the bounces are real. Windrun to get out. Cinnamon comes in. A Doom, but are they able to chase this one? Oh, he's so fast here right now. He throws out a shockwave as well. He follows him down to the depths of the earth. Queen of the... Oh, yeah,
oh,
Queen of Pain deny! And there's a second deny. This time he chased him down to make sure that he was able to get a kill, but the Queen of Pain says no. They don't need no jungle creeps to help them out now.
The plays.
Oh my god.
Great initiation. That was textbook initiation right there, and with the Magnus being microed as well, pretty good. Whoever was microing the Magnus, bang up job right there.
Yeah, there was. It was like so far on the end as well. Oh, yeah. On top, Queen of Pain goes in aggressively, and straight up has to run away with getting her call down and stuff. But the Undying is now here. Spectre comes in as well. They want his Gyrocopter. They want him badly. But he's so fast. Can I even catch up to him?
Yeah, like, just press Q and Jesus.
Okay, they committed for it, and they got it. 30 seconds down. Shockwave. Sonic Wave is down now as well. They had to use Hound as well.
Gold swing of 700. Not bad at all. Oh, it was still a free man rotation, and they get the disruptor on the mid lane.
Probably Shackle to remove creeps, I guess. As now
Ranger once again.
He's going for a Maelstrom build here. Okay, that's not something I was expecting.
What were you expecting? Cool. Like, four staff into Ags or something?
Yeah, maybe 4-7, maybe Blink even. Just Blink into to an Aghanims or something. And then you can just start blowing up our Aghanims into Blink. That's something.
Yeah, Maelstrom is very pushy, isn't it? Like,
If this is like what the team, if this was the team wants to do, then fine. But there's no one close to a mecha at the moment, so It's not they're not gonna group up, I would say, that much.
Maybe they're relying on the Undying getting it pretty quickly, but the problem is he just hasn't been present, really.
Yeah, like, this is an item that you want to use for split pushing and stuff like that. Not really a team fighting item, but I'm pretty sure that the Dire wants to try and get the team fights going, since they're a lot stronger in team fights right now than the Radiant are, especially with all the cooldowns now.
Yeah, definitely.
You can just take a fight, like, that's like what you want to do for head. Oh, 1 minute left and they're waiting for it. Who paused this? Lich paused this game while they're actually seeing the Magnus here, aren't they? You know, you can see like this beautiful vision from me. In the stream, radiant vision, bottom left.
I need to have a look at that.
Yeah, I'll leave it on for a bit. Like, you can see it. I need to get... I think they see him like barely here. At least they're gonna see him walking in now, poking his head, getting out. Switching over to the dive vision now. See how beautiful it is.
Nice. Very lovely.
My great photoshopping skills over there.
Some amazing Photoshop going there. Oh, what do we have going on bot?
Oh, that's gonna be a Death Spectre. This is not what they want.
Rotations.
There's a Shockwave ready. He wants to kill Secure with it. No, he just wants to slap him down. He might just die towards the Queen of Pain. Oh, he's just keeping out. He's too tanky to kill with the Scorcher.
What?
Yeah, well, that means every ability on cooldown, that means that you're gonna die. And now Windranger in a hole of trouble 2 seconds before she can Windrun. Is she gonna make it? No, she's not. Bit kills Moff and just TP's straight away underneath the tower. And yeah, they know they have no stuns here on the side of Raiden, so they just leave him alone.
That's a bit of pickoffs. That's just good pickoffs, you know, all around. Getting 700 gold points back.
Oh, Queen of Pain. Oh, space. Yeah, this might be a little problem. He's never gonna get his thing.
No.
That's a wasted RP. He can't fight this. He's gonna die. They even throw out the Sonic Wave here. That's pretty aggressive. And now they're stuck in the kinetic field. Oh no. Base one death. Queen of Pain death. And now what? The Koto. He's just running around. He tries to waste time, but die says, nope, you're not gonna waste your time. We just blow you up. Cinderin picks
you know
up the kill.
That commitment wasn't even worth it. They didn't even kill the Magnus.
Even a 5 to roll of this, I was like, yeah, this RP is not going to be good. It's just a waste RP, but yeah, they just completely turn around with a nice rotation here from the entire team, pretty much. Only thing is, never going to be seeing a Blink Dagger on the Magnesium.
Yeah, like, it's not going to happen.
At least they steal some items.
It's a shame, really, actually, because they've been microing him so well.
Yeah, he's actually still one of the top top levels here.
Yeah,
and top CS as well. Oh, they're committing here, by the way, for Cinderin on the bot. He just dooms out the Koto, trying to keep them back. He has mana drain on him. He's gonna get stunned up from this.
But it's still too tanky.
He can TP out, so he's gonna die eventually. Question is, can he take some gold with him?
Nah.
No. Not at all. He's dead. Set life for him. As Queen of Pain, there's just some potion on top of the Lich. Actually, I think we're seeing a Aghanim's first on the Doom here.
It's great.
He wants to break ability, so essentially that's Spectre and only Spectre.
He wants to make sure that the Dispersion is no longer a factor. He wants to make sure that Desolate is no longer a factor.
Yeah, like, you can only use it really against Spectre here. Like, apart from that, it's not really that big.
I think maybe... No, not even the Windranger. She's just... Yeah.
Oh, Magnus found. He does have a skewer to get out. Shockwave.
But this doesn't need it. I mean, Cinderin's there to help. If they want to commit something, they could. But yeah, now they've even got the Lich up here. But there's the rotations coming right back out.
Oh, Queen of Pain. Oh, they want to go for him. Yeah, they have a glimpse ready. They want to get this one. Oh, they just throw down the Static Storm, but this is like completely whiffed.
Yeah, Young Mad was stunned up right there before fight even started.
Yeah, that's not what they wanted there at all. They want to just get up. Quick easy set and just kill them off. That's the Windranger here. Finds a nice double sec-ish.
Yeah, let me just take that for you. Well, you probably don't need it if it's the case over the time. Finished a Maelstrom. You think she's gonna go straight up to a Mjolnir or build up into an Axe first?
I don't think the Mjolnir would be the correct item here, as we're actually gonna get the kill here with the Gyrocopter on the portal. Totem is down, Space is taking some damage, but should be able to just...
Ooh.
Oh no, Windranger comes in. Oh, doing a lot of damage to Mesh, but he's still alive here. A bit too tanky here with the point booster. Spectre has to come in, finish the job. Now Bit, he's gonna pursue him. So mana coming out here, and Bit says, yeah, I'm not gonna pursue this one. I stay back. Cinderin comes in as well. Completed Aghanim's here. They have to watch out a bit now.
That's a 17-minute tanks.
The one problem is it's level 1 Doom still, like, so... Yeah. Yeah, he needs to be close to really get it up. Or get it
no,
off, you know,
level
get...
1 Axe. Level 17 Axe. Minute 17 Axe.
But is he gonna get close? Like, that's the question. Like, he can just get shackled shots.
I mean, if the keeper of the light is YOLO plays like that, then yeah, he is.
But so if he gets up his mana drain after that, he can just run back and then you use your Doom on a Koto. It's a Koto. Who the hell cares?
Oh, here comes the cooldown.
Yeah, they're not gonna pursue this. You're gonna get the double off on A here, but. Gets a nice chunk of damage, but that's about all.
Doom leading on net worth, as expected. Devour all that extra gold. Oh, Disruptor is gonna get very ganked here. Oh dear.
He's trying to gank the Spectre here, but not that, you know, he's gonna get ganked himself. He's gonna get the glimpse of on Spectre, but it's still next to it, and now he's just all stuck here. Keeper of the Light Doom. Picking up Doom. No, Blinding Light just in time knocks him out. Now he's there. He's gonna get the Doom up onto the wind range here. He's gonna
split.
Die. She's gonna die. She's gonna be deaf here fairly soon. There you go. Shockwave killing it up. However, Queen of Pain comes in for Messi. Have no stuns at all to kill off the Lich here, and he will survive. Now Cinderin also TP's out. That is the big flaw in the Radiant side here. One stun on the Wind Ranger. Stuns. It's not going to be enough.
I mean, does Blinding Light cancel TP's? I think it does, doesn't it?
Hmm? Blinding Light?
Blinding Light.
No.
Blinding Light.
No. It's the same as Force Staff. See it like that. It just knocks you back, but doesn't stop anything.
Damn it. Okay. Explains a lot.
That explains why you lost some pups, or
Yeah.
What? Nothing to be done about it.
I don't play too much Koppel. Let's just put it that way.
But yeah, that's it. And we're gonna see you fairly soon, Sanjay Yasha here on the Gyrocopter, just tanking up a bit. And really just still playing like 5 men. This Magnus is just being micro to death.
And the Cinderin is no support from his team, and he's going, I'm too tanky for you to kill me. I've got a plate mail now. I'm going AC.
Yeah.
You guys will not be able to kill me anytime soon, so I'll just farm up your jungle because you guys can't do anything about it. And here comes
It's not going to be an AC. It's going to be Shivas.
Oh. Yes, of course.
Like, it's... You're playing against a Koto with the mana drain. Like, you're going to get it.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, actually, AC doesn't make any sense this game, does it? I mean,
yeah, you're not really going for the towers yet.
Oh, what was that RP though?
Doesn't matter. Still get the kill.
Still actually killing the gyro.
Oh, now Koto comes in. Yeah, that was maybe a little bit too aggressive. Gets slowed up, and Shockwave is there. No, still alive, and he just keeps on running. No need to stop here as the Doom tries to pursue it. Scorched Earth comes up, and there's Doom. Is it gonna be a deny? Then he needs to run towards the Wind Ranger, or yeah. I don't think it was the correct play to run towards them dying here.
Ah, Wind Ranger completely, yeah.
Yeah, more damage, further range, more chance of dying still, I guess. He's getting denied. As we're gonna see, two more minutes, but should see the Radiance on the Spectre here.
Oh well, that's great. A 20-minute Radiance versus a Doom who has an Axe and a Plate Mail.
I said they just have to hold off all the time here on the rain side. This is all they need to do. Just buy times. In late game, it all depends on whether or not Doom can get a refresher and can get the Doom off on the Wind Ranger plus the Spectre. Like, Queen of Pain is still going to be a bit of an annoying factor, but still, you should be able to survive through it. Especially
since
she's
got
still
heals. Be careful, you know, because the team fight on both teams is just incredible. It's... Like, if the Dire managed to get a good team fight off, there is nothing that Radiant will do. Because if the Radiant managed to get a good team fight off, the Dire can easily counter initiate.
I would say that the Dire has a stronger team fight though.
Yeah.
Especially towards the late game. And Glimpse back on the Dying, they just want this tower, and should be able to get it now.
And that tower.
Oh, they're actually. They don't know that they're here.
Oh dear, that's 5-man rotation?
They just look at the Dire Vision. They see the Spectre standing here. They don't see the Undying behind it now. He walks actually back here as they're just backing up a bit, standing back.
This would actually be like a perfect split push moment.
Well, they actually, every time they walk in front of the tower, they can actually see them coming in here. They know that there are more people, so you can just see them walking back or At least setting up for a fight here. So there's going to be an aggressive blink in. RP! Oh, no. Still whiffed on the second time as well. As now the Windranger is caught out. Is he able to kill off Jungmin? No! Just on a little shimmer of HP gets out. Actually not. Spectre is there. Now Windranger is stuck there. Yeah, Doom on you. Blinding Light helping the Magnus getting a little bit closer here. Now Fury is going to get... Oh, Fury, actually. It's not Fury. It's Fury.
Yeah.
Did not know that. Windranger dies finally to the Magnus. Not looking at that. Just looking at the... And dying, getting killed here as Cinnamon Dota gets another killing spree.
Yeah.
Radiance completed at least at 22 minutes, about, so. Correct on that one.
Three quad farm yields 25 minutes. Nice. Someone's salty.
Yeah, Fury is not happy at all.
Yeah, no, I don't. Yeah. Even if she was free farming, she has died twice and zero kills.
Yeah, she's not. Yeah, like the two assists don't really matter that much. It's about, like, what is it, 100, 200 gold ish.
Oh, and now she's even stealing far from the Spectre. That's.
Using a Sonic Wave. Oh, man, she is salty at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
Salty as hell. I'm not completely sure if she actually took the big one. I think actually.
She did.
She got it still? Okay. Still, like, I don't think the Spectre cares that much about it because it's just one stack, you know, or one camp. It's back now already. So, but still, it means a cooldown of 2 minutes in Eastern Grave. Like, that's a salty play. If you ever seen one.
Just so much sodium right there. But. Right now, yeah, the Radiant is doing exactly what you said.
They're just holding off. I forgot to put the network on. 23 minutes. Holy
Whoa.
Shit! I'm gonna fill up my coffee again. Like, this is shameful. I'm just gonna follow the Doom for 20 seconds while you can have the call.
So yes, the Doom. He has a Sheba's Guard and an Ags. That at 23 minutes. That just goes to show how much gold game helps, I guess. So, but there's a blink up on the Windranger with the Maelstrom. Probably going to build up to an X item, most likely going to be an X, I assume. He might go something else, but there's nothing else I can really think of that would make sense.
BKB is pretty terrible.
Yeah, but
again.
BKB at this stage, yeah, no.
It doesn't really help that much anymore.
It's like the Doom not... already has an X, it's no point.
And it might just be a Death Spectre here. God on hits.
He's a bit more.
130 HP. Nope. Oh no. Blink. Shackle.
Ah, trying. Space yeah. Trying.
What a time just to get the pickups.
Alvius. Chasing Young Mad. Chasing Space. He's even got herself a Chakra Magic there. And no.
Yeah, that's a dead space. Like, how the hell did Shackles? I would never know, but still.
They need to make Shackles more consistent. I swear the angle sometimes is just...
Yeah, that was like two updates ago that they did that stuff. And actually Queen of Pain is able to TP out from now. From bottom lane.
And Spectre is still not... It's like a complete reverse of the situation we had earlier. They commit everything on the Spectre and she manages to stay alive. And now the Magnus is starting to fall off because the level 1 RP...
Level 2.
Oh, well, she's level, level 12.
She's level 12. She's actually pretty much in the middle of the pack, and that says a lot since she's the middle of the pack. It means the same as the Queen of Pain and just like two levels behind the Spectre. Like level wise, it's doing okay. Farm-wise,
yeah, but I mean net worth. It's like, you know, he's never gonna have a blink. He's never gonna have any good items. So it's like his only use is he's gonna be able to skewer in and keep people.
That's the whole thing about that hero this game, or at least how he's gonna get played. Now, he's just gonna be the suicidal pawn. Like, just throw him in and let him die. Like, who cares?
He doesn't have any net worth.
Yeah, like, you know, he dies, you give some XP, well, woohoo, if you can get one or two kills back for it, who the hell cares?
Like, well, maybe Radiant can predict that. Maybe they can counter it somehow, but, you know.
Also, the passive gold gain really helps out, of course, the dire side. Like, because of that, the supports are getting farm. We are gonna now see an Agnes completed on Disruptor.
Love that item.
Yeah, if you're now gonna get any type of BKB, you might as well not, as they're actually not even trying to build up for one.
The Spectre just going straight for the Sanchin Yasha. Oh no, the Master Stall, sorry.
So, like, the correct play to make now is Doom, probably the Spectre, and throw the Windranger in the static storm kinetic field combination and just, you know, have them all junked out later. If you did get those two already, you pretty much won the team fight. You have a salty Queen of Pain anyway, so.
Queen of Pain's not gonna. I mean, she's doing okay, but.
It doesn't middle of the back yet. Oh, that's a pretty terrible kinetic storm. Or kinetic field, static storm combination. That was like nowhere even close. As the 52 Keeper of the Light last set hit there on the rocket. He's actually going for Linkus as well. Oh no, doomed. Shiva's guard. Slowed as hell and eaten.
And goodbye, Queen of Pain. And yeah. Bit as well, deciding he wants a bit of the action. Wants to follow the Undying, but decides to not.
Very tanky with the 1400 HP though. 1 DK is pretty much loses a big chunk of it. At least they now have a about 28 minute mecha on the Undying. Like, it's not.
It's a consolation. It's a consolation. But yeah. Now Dire are going rush.
Do they have? Yeah, they saw all of this with the Radiant Vision here.
They can't contest though. They're too spread out.
Yeah, they're all top there. Spectre just looking for a tower. Dependable on how fast rush goes down, they might actually be looking for a tier 3. Just keep on pushing now. You kind of know that they're there because you can see them walking there with the vision that they have. So if they just commit to the push here, they might actually be able to do some significant damage, but they're not committing at the moment. Rush is now starting to get down to half HP, but they're actually backing
up. Coming in to assist. Yeah, but they didn't want to contest. They can't. They still can't. They're too spread out.
Yeah, like at best, what they can do is Spectre ult, steal the Aegis. Wait, does he have space for it? He doesn't, so
maybe,
he has to drop.
Maybe that's the plan.
Like, Dying took the illusion rune from the Spectre, so he's a bit salty as well. I can't imagine what's going on in the team chat right now.
I want to know. I just want to know so bad.
I believe the Spectre is... Yeah, he has a Twitch stream. Maybe you could go check that one out.
Well, they managed to get the Aegis, so... And yeah, there's no consequence of that, except that they lost a tier 2. Which is fine for them, I guess. I mean, they probably don't care too much.
Nah, you lose
now they can
you
just
some.
Push. Yeah, maybe they can just now push the mid lane.
Yeah, it's just a classic trade, losing a tower for rush. Like, nothing too bad, nothing too big.
Windrange up here. Yep, she's going for an axe now, so... Wants to get that damage. An insane damage, but
Glimps back in Windranger, runs the other way. He's gonna get a homing missile after him. They drop down the totem as well. They're just gonna pursue this.
They're all blinded.
Yeah,
no, they can't.
Yeah. Oh, what? What? That was.
They had a mini stun on the Lich ult.
Motherfucker, 0.1. I actually thought she was out. Like, okay, she's out. I thought she actually cancelled that one herself. Like, she sees it incoming. Because it's kind of weird that it hits you before you're TP'd out. Like, before the animation comes to you, you're actually stunned. That's weird.
It's...
That shouldn't be like that.
Not very conservative usage of the Lich Ult, but you know, you get a Windranger kill, and she's one of the top threats right now after the Spectre.
Yeah, and
so it's good, very good.
If she's dead, they can't fight. That's also how it goes. Like, they need the Windranger to fight.
Yeah. They can't fight without the Windranger. She's just currently the DPS that they have. The Spectre just, I mean, now she has a Manta and she has a Radiant, so now she can deal some pretty good damage, but,
She's like this AoE damage kind of thing.
Yeah.
Not really solo target, so, no, it's pretty much everything is like AoE apart from the Windranger. And you can't kill Doom with just AoE.
Here we go, Doom is invis with an invis rune.
Yeah.
Looking for the Spectre, I'm going to...
Yeah, but he's walking right underneath his entry. Here you go. Seen. Completely seen here. And
there you go. And he doesn't have any health.
Nope.
He doesn't even get the Doom off.
Yeah. What if he gets the Doom off? That just means that the Doom is on cooldown for, 80 seconds? 100 seconds, actually. It's not even worth to get it off. Because it will just survive or deny it anyway.
Maybe they might have been able to use that as an excuse for initiation, but like the Doom walking around on his own that far up with the rest of his team that far back, not sure what they were thinking exactly.
He's just trying to get a pickoff, but you know, having a sentry there, that kind of just makes sure that you can't.
Yeah.
Always.
I don't know, at this stage of this team, at this stage of this
game?
Yeah. God damn it.
Well, that's where we're doing this practice.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, I would assume, like, more teams coordination and less trying to get pickoffs. Because just looking at how the Raven have been playing for the last 10 minutes, it's like they've been playing pretty close together, bunched up. And they know the Magnus can't do anything anymore. So it's like going in on their own, there's no pickoff potential. There's not so much pickoff potential for the Doom, especially that far up into the base.
Actually, Cinnamon went now for a Blink Dagger. That's pretty ballsy here. Since that they
have
so
those pickoffs.
Like I really just like getting a Shadow Blade in these kind of games more. Because now here you go, they just initiate on him. And what does he have of his Blink Dagger now? He is stuck there, that does mean that Windrange is not stuck as well. But it doesn't matter, I already popped Windrun, so not taking a lot of damage. No, they can't deny it. Glimpse back there as well. Oh, they want more. He's just gonna follow, throw down the ult, but what does it matter? It does some damage, Force Step is there, they can still see it, of course, here with the, what the hell was the name of that? Fucking hell. I'm linking out Thunderstrike. Oh, fall down. Nope, he's gonna get out.
Same. Commitment there, but they only kill off the Windrange, which is okay, I guess, but they lose the Doom for it, which isn't so good.
Man,
and
really
the Spectra. Look at the Spectra's network.
Yeah, he just farming it up. Getting close to whatever item he wants next. Could be a Scotty. Nice item versus the Doom, make sure they can't get out. Maybe you still go for a Diffusal back. And just have this incredible mana burn on your team. Or just opt to go for like a straight up heart.
Going hard.
Yeah, heart. More normal.
Yeah, the Gyro can't compare. The Gyro can't compare at the moment. He's 2,000 behind the Spectre.
So it's. So Spectre is just gonna kill your backlines if you can get off a strong flat cannon, so.
It's like this, they're idling, they're just waiting, they're just letting the Spectra farm up elsewhere while they stop the Dire push wherever it happens.
And yeah, you're playing 4v5, you need to take a fight. You need to force a fight, get the kills and get push from there. Because if you're waiting, Radiant in the end have always one person here. Even if the heroes aren't as strong late game, you still have an extra person.
And you still have like an extra, you know, you still have extra items. Like, Albus Cockle is starting getting axe, he has a 4-star. Who, the other support, like Undying, who has a mech.
There we go.
They're not playing very well right now.
Yeah, like this is just, the Windranger blinks just destroys everybody, that's why I say get a blink.
Yeah.
Like if you get a blink and Windranger, you pretty much can get anybody killed. Like it's just that easy.
But like I was saying, like they've got a 4-star on the Keep of Light. They've had the Undying with the mech and the Arcane Boots now going to get a Vlad. You've got these extra Aurea carriers, you've got these extra item slots that you can use. Whereas the Radiant, the Dire, they don't. The Magnus doesn't work. Can't carry anything anymore because it doesn't have any gold.
Yeah, he still has the same items that he has in the beginning.
So they effectively have 6 of support items less because.
Oh, well, that doesn't matter if they can kill the Cuddle here. The Lich Shield's a little bit. Well, underestimated here, or underused, I would say, as Morality might have some friends cutting my over.
No, it's fine. Why does everyone fit? It's just the bell sounds throughout the house, that's the problem.
That's fine. At least it's better. Have you ever heard my my bell?
No, the Disruptor. What a shackle.
Yeah, this is. Looking at the tree is still there, nobody cut that one down.
I wouldn't be surprised if they just decide to like rage cut down that tree.
Yeah, like just skewer through it to destroy it.
Fuck that tree in particular.
But yeah, it's gonna be tough now. At least now you can use the Magnus more effectively. But yeah,
I think they have to use the Magnus somehow. They need the RPs. I think that's a. That's something they really need. I think they really need a good RP.
Yeah, just to combo it up with Lich Ultimate and with the Static Storm. Like, if you can just get this RP combination off on 2 or 3, then you can get the others with the Doom, and then you just pretty much win the game.
But you can't idle with this lineup, and that's the problem. That's exactly what they're doing. Quidditch Pain has managed to build up a Lincolns.
Yeah.
Undying is Vlad's. He's probably going to get Guiding Grooves next.
This Queen of Pain is such a scary to get. Oh, there's Doom has come out. They're gonna go after the Windrange. She's kind of just accepting her fate and just trying to fight up as just an incredible level death coming out and just completely destroying her. They get a kill on the wind range, and maybe now they're able to finally do something here, because Spectre just keeps on pushing out everything with the Radiance illusions. I just don't care that much. Queen of Pain is also split pushing, like...
They haven't even taken the tier 1 top. They really need to do that now.
Yeah, they will be able to do that, most likely. Like, it's... But still, it's some gold, like, I guess, but still, it's not really...
Yeah, it's the Undying.
Map objective. Oh, yeah. There's gonna be the Force Staff coming out. They're gonna use the Spectre ultimate to come after it. Sinner, when he gets knocked back here with the Blinding Light, they're just gonna leave him for now, as they just wanna go for the Lich here and make sure the Fury lives through. Sinner and TP's out. And no, there's gonna be the use from the Queen of Pain. Oh, Spectre's all ready for this. Sonic Wave on top of it. NGSPCL is dominating. And Lich, disconnect from the game. He says, I'm done. This is not a game we're gonna win anymore. I'm done. Guys, good luck. Fuck this, I'm gonna accept my loss in MMR.
I mean, the abandon was so late that right now they still need to win the game to get the MMR. Game, but, it happens.
And this is gonna be a tough game to get back from. I still don't agree with the Blink Dagger. I can get why you get it out of me if you can get a jump on somebody, but...
Yeah, but it's not gonna happen.
Yeah, even...
Even if he does fight someone on his own,
yeah,
like,
even if you
gonna have backup.
Yeah, even if you get a jump on someone, the thing that's gonna happen next is that they... Oh, no, this is gonna be... Oh, they don't see the Magnus here. It was like a 1 HP Magnus. Like one Radiant Stake and he's dead.
It's another problem.
They see him here with Radiant Fist. Can he deny himself? Oh yeah, now they see him again. There you go. But yeah, just to follow up, like, even let's say you jump on someone, you get off your doom. In the end, if the Spectre is the one still alive, he uses Hunt. You're not ever gonna be able to use it again. If you don't use it on the Wind Ranger and you use it on, let's say, Spectre, then he blinks after you and shackles you and you're dead as well. Like, you either need the BKB or Shadowblade. Like, that's what you need. And then build up
the
refresher.
Doom is like 5,300 gold right now, so...
He needs a refresher now, like, I almost forgot. If you want to win, he needs a refresher.
Oh, he got BKB.
He goes BKB, yeah. That's... As I said,
that's okay. That's okay.
Yeah. Now it's all gonna depend on his finger dexterity. As it's now 5 versus 2 with the Disruptor dead.
Disrupt the stake.
Yeah, like, he's like, yeah, dude, you're still farming our jungle. Like, to be honest, forgot. Just play it safe on the race. I just keep on farming, so fuck it. You have now 2 extra slots. As Lich has absolutely nothing to help his team.
It's like, Spectre's just like, I've got a heart now. I'm going to keep keeping you down, and there is nothing you can do, because all the DPS you have is non-existent.
Yeah, oh, Queen of Pain goes in and uses herself as that's actually good level death into a Doom.
Nice.
That does mean a death Queen of Pain here.
Wow, what a
Wind
good
Ranger
what a
doesn't
good
have wind run, taking a lot of damage, still fairly low. She needs to get out. This homing missile won't kill her since it's still level 1. And Spectre manning up versus the Gyrocopter, and Gyrocopter Rocket Barrage is doing absolutely nothing. That's a level that saves her! Oh my god, now Magnus is in there! He's gonna die here easily. And Cinnamon Dota. Trying to man up, go CP out as Queen of Pain. Oh no, that was a beautiful play there. Beautiful mana drain into Force F to keep him out, and this is GG.
No,
Sidra
fights back. They want to go right back in on this.
But this Disruptor, like, he's trying to man up, but it's a fucking Disruptor. What's he gonna do? This is not gonna work out at any time. Anyways, Mets, yeah. Not gonna do. What's he gonna do?
There's the GG.
Yeah, like. Doesn't mean anything, they still need to destroy the Asia. Cinnery might be a bit salty and just defend till the end.
He is after all, Cinnery.
Force F forward from the Cult of Arrow on him. He just used the Shiva, I guess, using to the air. They're setting it up, putting down a nice totem. And really anti-comedic kill here. As they're now just all disconnecting here.
There's no real climax to this game, I feel like.
Ah, Radiant just did what they had.
Yeah. They just stopped, you know. They just stopped pushing, they just stopped fighting. They stand back, they idle. Stop the Radiant at their pushes and, you know, got the pick-offs. And in the end, won. That's how it works.
Yeah, just using those extra slots that you have versus the passive gold gain that's increased for the Dire. But still, maybe if they lost their Lich, then I would say, like, Dire would have had a bit more of a chance, just because then they have the big initiation tools.